Hi guys, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget, please share, subscribe, and thumbs up my videos. There in New Jersey, there was two earthquakes today, a magnitude 2.3 and a 1.7, along the Ramapo Fault Zone, not far from Manhattan, or New York City, or Queens. It was in Morris County. The first earthquake at 5:14 p.m. local time. They say it was near White Meadow Lake, New Jersey. 34 people said they felt that earthquake. USGS gave it an intensity level of 5. So here we got 4 from there, but they gave it an intensity level of 5, which means it was felt by most people. There was some breakage of dishes, maybe cracks in the windows, plaster, the walls, disturbance of tall objects. You might want to check your water and gas lines. And then at 6:37 p.m. local time, there was the 1.7. 3 people said they felt that earthquake, and it was given an intensity level of 3. So it would have been felt indoors by people, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing automobiles would have been rocking slightly. Would have been a vibration like a passing truck. The earthquake would have lasted, or felt like it lasted, for about 30 seconds. And it was less than 3 miles west of Morris Plains in Morris County, and was about 3 miles below the ground. This was the largest earthquake to strike the area since 2015, when they had a magnitude 2.6. That was near Mendon, just a few miles away from today's earthquake. Some people describe the earthquake like maybe a truck had hit the house. Others in Morristown reported a loud noise. The noise was reported of hearing probably the quake from Randolph, Rockaway, Devonville, and even Chester. On Twitter, KL Walpole said that she is 50 years old and experienced her first earthquake today. I live in New Jersey, and yes, we do have a minor fault line here. Yes, California, I know a 2.3 is not that big, but it's my first, and I'm very weirdly excited about this. The Ramapo Fault is the longest fault in the Northeast. It begins in Pennsylvania and moves into New Jersey, trending northeast through Hutterston, Somerset, Morris, Passaic, and Bergen. It terminates in New York's Westchester County, not far from the Indian Point Energy Center, a nuclear power plant. The largest known quake to strike the area was in 1783. Somewhere, they're not sure, west of New York City, perhaps in Sussex County. Then they list it as a magnitude 5.3. They're not really sure, they're just guessing by old reports. In 1884, there was an earthquake of either a magnitude 5 or 5.5 off New York City's Rockaway Beach. It pulled houses off their foundations and caused steeples to topple as far west as Rahway. The shaking then was felt as far as Vermont to Maryland. They don't have earthquake standards like they do on the West Coast, and earthquakes are rare. They say the chance of a large earthquake along the East Coast is relatively small, and being that way, they don't have earthquake standards like they do on the West Coast for building codes. There is a link about the different types of soil, which areas are more susceptible to earthquakes. Class E, which is soft soils. You see Morris up over here, Essex, Hudson. Yeah, those are dangerous areas. Class D, which is kind of like the orange color there. Stiff soil. The yellow is very dense soil and soft rock. Green would be rock. And then the aqua blue would be hard rock. Those are probably the areas the safest for structures. So did you feel or hear these two earthquakes? If so, please put those comments down below. Did you have any damage? Put that down below too. Please like, share, and thumbs up my videos. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.